Hello dear student, I welcome you all in Highway Engineering subject and the subject code is 1615504. Today we are going to see unit number 4, that is construction of road pavements and material, and that this is lecture number 10. Myself Daniel Tommy, I am lecturer of Civil Department, GEMS Polytechnic College, Aurangabad, Bihar. Let us discuss about the content of the lecture. In construction of road pavements and material, today we will discuss about what is bituminous road, different types of bituminous surface, bituminous road construction and steps and procedure, advantage and disadvantages of bituminous road. Let us discuss about these four topics in detail. First of all, we will see what is bituminous road. Bituminous road consists of their surface with bitumen material, which is also called as asphalt. The material which bitumen road contain, it is also called as asphalt. It is sticky, dark, viscous liquid obtained from natural deposit like crude petroleum. As we know, from petroleum tar we get, by processing of crude petroleum we will get bitumen, we will get diesel and all. In that, bituminous is a material which is used in a road construction. Here is the image of cross-sectional image of the bituminous road. Let us see about this. As you can see, here is at the bottom there will be the base course. According to tonnage, they will provide the thickness of that. Then leveling course, we will level that. After that, course binder we will provide to bind the level course, and after course binder we will provide surface course, and the surface course will be the second last course, and above surface course seal coat will be provided to seal that surface course that will bear the load and distribute the load to the base course. Next is different type of bituminous surface. First is primary coat. This is a single coat of a lowest viscosity bitumen binder. This coat is applied to excess untreated previously layer like WBM. The main purpose is to improve the adhesion between the base and the bituminous surface, which means that the sticky property. Primary coat is a single coat which have low viscosity, as we can see here, low viscosity bitumen binder, and this coat is used in WBM road, that is waterborne macadam road, and the main purpose is to improve the adhesiveness between the base course and the bituminous surface. You can understand. And the function of primary coat is that the most important function is to improve the adhesiveness between the previous base and the bearing surface, and to bind the dust and the loose particle together to form hard and tough surface. Primary coat will tighten the loose particle and make a tough surface. It provide temporary seal and to prevent the surface water to penetrate through the surface. It also help, it is a temporary seal which also help to which also helps to penetrate, prevent the water to penetrate inside the base course, and this is also helpful to preventing the water, and this will make the loose particle tougher and stronger, and the surface will be tough surface. Second one is tack coat. This is a single coat of a low viscosity bitumen binder applied to existing treatment in previous layer such as bituminous or cement concreting base. This coat is applied between the treated base and the bituminous surface. This tack coat is having low viscous bitumen binder, and it is used to improve the thickness and as well as the strength of that, and it is used in bituminous or in cement concrete base, and this coat is applied between the base course and the bituminous surface. The function of this tack coat is to provide and to improve the adequate bond between the existing impervious base and the wearing base. Primary coat and tack coat both helps in same manner, but they are different types of coat which is used in bituminous road. Next is third one is seal coat. Seal coat is a final coat of a bitumen material that is applied on the top of the surface to prevent the entry of moisture through voids. Seal coat is to prevent the moisture, you can see, prevent the entry of moisture through voids. The important word for seal coat is a surface which prevent the entry of moisture through voids, and it is applied at the top of the surface, and it is the final coat of the bituminous material. The function of seal coat is it provide watertight surface to improve the visibility at night and display skidding resistant texture, and to improve the wearing resistant of the existing road surface. This is the function of seal coat. Next is surface dressing. It is a process in which two or more coats of bituminous material are applied to prepare the base. This coat consists of bituminous binder spread on which chips aggregates are properly rolled. Surface dressing is nothing but it is where, as I have told you earlier, that when we will put or lay the coarse aggregate on a base course, there will be irregularities and there will be chips on the tops. By providing a load or compacting by the roller, that aggregate will be in regular form and the profile of that layer will be in regular form and the profile will be good. At that process, surface dressing should be needed, and the surface dressing is a process in which two or more coats of bitumen material is applied to prepare the base. As we know the coats, it can be primary or tack or seal coat. The two coats will be two coats of bitumen will be applied on that. After that, the coat consists of bitumen binders spread in on which the chips aggregates are properly rolled. After that coat, the bitumen and bitumen binder which consists of chips of aggregate, that will be spread, and above that roller will roll it, and it will be properly fixed. As you can see, जो पिच रोड रहता है उसमें क्या होता है, बिटमन और जो छोटा वाला गिट्टी होता है वो मिक्स होता है, और उसको उस रोड पे बिछाया जाता है, उसका जो मतलब सील कोट डाल के या कोई मतलब प्राइमरी कोट या कोई कोट डाल के, ये तीनों में से कोई कोट डाल के, दो कोट डालने के बाद इसको क्या करते हैं, बिटमिनस मटेरियल और गिट्टी को वो जो मिक्सर रहता है जो इंडस्ट्री से आता है उसको हम लोग बिछाते हैं। उसको बिछाने के बाद हम उसको उसको रोलर से कॉम्पैक्ट करते हैं। कॉम्पैक्ट करने के बाद एक प्रॉपर उसका प्रोफाइल आता है, रोड का प्रोफाइल आ जाता है, जिसमें हमको स्किडिंग रेसिस्टेंट का भी मतलब ध्यान रखते हुए वो हमको दिखता है। और फंक्शन इसका क्या है, लेट अस सी द फंक्शन ऑफ द सरफेस ड्रेसिंग। इट इम्प्रूव द रिमूवल ऑफ बाइंडर मटेरियल एंड प्रिवेंट द डैमेज ऑफ रोड ड्यू टू वाटर प्रूफिंग इफेक्ट्स। रोड कैन बी इजली क्लीन एंड वॉश एंड as it reduces the dust nuisance. Smooth surface of the road reduces the wear and tear of tires. As we provide smooth surface of road, in that the wear and tear of tires can be reduced as well as, and if we clean and wash, it will reduce the pollution nuisance, it will reduce the dust nuisance, as well as it will prevent it prevents the removal of binding material and prevent the damage of road due to waterproofing effect on the road, and there will be no penetration of water, and so the bituminous road will be go for longer, and the age of that road will be longer if there is no penetration of water and if it act as a waterproof agents. Next is bituminous road construction step and procedure. First is bituminous penetration water macadam road. This type of bituminous road, the aggregate are bonded together with grouting bitumen into the voids of compacted aggregate, and this type of bitumen road is generally adopted for the thickness of 50 to 75 mm. This first is bituminous penetration macadam road, which means that by the name itself we can understand, after the rolling of roller on coarse aggregate, there will be many voids, and the voids will be sealed by the bitumen. So and the thickness of that bitumen will be 50 to 75, and this is named as bitumen penetration macadam road. Next is material required. The grade of bitumen to be used for the type of road is suggested by Indian Road Congress, that is IRC, range from 80 by 100, 60 by 70, 30 by 40. Any one of the above grade can be adopted. Road tires of grade such as RT4, RT5 can also be used. Physical property of the aggregate must be fulfill the following standard test value given below. These are the bituminous which can be used in a road paving, but it should the physical properties of this bitumens should fulfill the requirement of standard test value. As we will see, these are the materials which is used in bituminous road. The material required is Los Angeles abrasion value, that is maximum percentage it should get 40%, aggregate impact value it should get 30, and Flexness index we should get 25, and stripping at 40 degrees after 24 hour immersing in CRR test we should get 25. These are the required value we should get so it can be used for bitumen road. Next is equipments and plants requirements. Bituminous heating device, bituminous distributor, roller for compacting operation, and aggregate spreader. These are the instrument which is needed for the laying of bituminous road. Construction procedure of bituminous penetration macadam road. Let us see the procedure how the construction of bituminous penetration macadam road will be formed. Preparation of existing surface. First of all the surface on which the bitumen macadam is to be applied is cleaned and from dust and other debris. It should be cleaned from other debris so that there should be when we lie there should be no any undulation on the surface, and the grade and the gradient and the camber of the road is properly checked. Primary coat can also be applied if necessary for the porous surface. In this bituminous penetration macadam road, we can apply primary coat to avoid the porous surface, and the gradient and the camber should be always checked by engineer who is there for the supervision. And if the gradient and camber is properly on the road, there will be no any logs of water, and the edge of that road will be maximum, and if the compaction is proper, then the road condition also will be good, and there will be less maintenance in that road, and there will be no rots or voids in that road, because there will be a good compaction. Spreading of coarse aggregate. Spreading of coarse aggregate can be done manually or by machine to achieve a desired profile. In a cross section template coat or a camber profile may be used. Means it can be spread by manually or it can be spread by machine, and it should be spread like this, because if it is spread like this, this height will be the camber. As we see, this forms a triangle. The height in this will tell about the camber of the road. Second thing is rolling operation. After spreading of aggregate, they are dried roll with a maximum tonnage of 10 tons roller. It is assumed that the aggregate are properly compacted and interlocked. If we are using 10 tons of rollers with vibration, it will compact and interlock properly, and there will be no voids, and it will interlock the material very tightly, and it will act as a waterproofing. Next is bituminous application. The uniform layer of bituminous binder is applied on the dry roller compacted aggregate with the help of pressure distributor or mechanical hand sprayer. The bituminous application will be spread on the roller compacted aggregate with the help of distributor or mechanical hand sprayer. And next is spreading of key aggregate. Once the bitumen is properly applied, the key aggregates are applied and laid, and rolling operation again continue for a proper compaction. Cross profile is also checked at the same time. Means that spreading of key aggregate, and after that the roller operation also continue for a proper compaction of key aggregates, and the cross profile of the bituminous road will be checked at the same time for the good profile. Next is seal coat application. If the road is going to be made and open for traffic and another surface course is not required, then seal coat is applied. It consists of sand, bitumen, or it may be a surface dressing type. Seal coat can be applied for a bituminous road which is going to be open for traffic or another surface is not to be laid. Then we can use seal coat, because the voids contained in the bituminous road will be covered with seal coat, and this seal coat is consist of sand, bituminous, and or a surface dressing type, and it will bind all it will remove all the voids, and it will provide smooth surface finishing. Cross profile of the road should be checked with the templates, and longitudinal profile by straight edging of road. The permissible undulations on 3 meter is 12 mm. Means the permission of undulation can be given as in 3 meter there should be undulation of 12 mm. It can be okay, but more than that, that is not okay. We should while construction we should provide a good camber and the soil and the road profile, means what the layer profile of different layers we should check, and the site supervision should be taken care, so that if the site supervision is taken care properly, there will be no any problem or any undulation on the surface, and the bitumen road will be good, open to traffic. The road is made to open to traffic after a minimum of 24 hours after construction. Means if a bitumen road is constructed after 24 hours, it can be used for traffic, and this is one of the main advantage of this bitumen road. Next is bitumen carpet road. In the construction of bitumen carpet road, the recommended bitumen binder is 80x100 grade, and the tar required should be, the grade is RT3. as we can use in bitumen carpet road, we should use the bitumen binder as 80 by 100, and the tar what we use, the grade is RT3. The stone chips required for 2 cm carpet thickness should be 12 mm, and the 12 and 10 mm below table should be required for the satisfy of aggregate, and these are the tests should be tested for the aggregate, that is Los Angeles abrasion test, and it should maximum percentage should be 35, flexness index 30 should be there, aggregate impact value 30 should be there, and strip value 25 should be there, water absorption 20 should be there. And in bituminous carpet road, all the same procedure will be done according how the penetration bituminous penetration macadam road procedure, same like that this bituminous carpet road also will be constructed. After that it will be open to traffic, and open to traffic is the road is open to traffic after 24 hour of application of seal coat or a surface dressing. After the finishing of bituminous coat road, then it should be left for 24 hours. After 24 hours, this is ready for the traffic. The advantage of bituminous road: generally bituminous road do not develop cracks on a surface for a longer period. Maintenance cost of this road is very less. Bituminous road are the waterproofing, non-slippery, smooth, durable, and it provide comfortable road surface for the traffic. It can withstand the adhesive natural effect caused by heavy rain, excess heat, and change in temperature. These are some of the advantage of bituminous road. The disadvantages of bituminous road: the viscosity of bituminous road and aggregate mix play an important role in a definite and perform the bituminous road. If the bitumen material is used in excess, then the value of given mix, it affect the performance of bituminous road. This affect the performance of bituminous road if the bitumen material is used in excess value in a given mix, and the performance will decrease, and it will affect the performance of the road. Summary of this lecture is all about bituminous road. Bituminous road are those which are painted with a bitumen material at its surface, and these are the high cost cost roads. The main function of providing a seal coat on a bitumen surface are under to make the surface watertight and to provide more desirable surface texture. These are the things which we have studied in this lecture. I have referred from online source SK Kannan book and Ritu publication book. Thank you for listening my lecture. If you have any doubt, you can directly contact me. Thank you.